Hello, welcome back to Wudang Academy and our new series of videos. I'm the translator at the Academy. We are a school of Wudang Sanfengpai in Austria, promoting Taoist culture, philosophy, and martial art practice. In this series of videos, we go through an interview we did with Master Yuan Xiugang. He is our Shi Ye, the Grand Master. In each video, we will go through one question from the interview followed by English translation. Now we will enter the first clip of the first question. In the first half of the interview, we asked Shi Ye to interpret selected sections from the DaoDeJing. It is the most important writing of the Chinese Taoist culture. Now we look at the video.
你好，师傅。 请师父解释一下《道德经》的一些部分的章节的含义。《道德经》里面第五，天地之间，其忧橐于，橐曰夫，虚而不屈，动而远出，多言数穷，不如守中。这个含义请师父解释一下。刚才还是说的这个《道德经》呢。 还是我还是要重复一下这个意思啊，因为《道德经》这个各有各人的理解，是吧？他可能你是存在的是，在字面上面去理解的话，都可能大部分时间都自己的有自己的理解去讲，对不对？啊，去猜测或者说去揣摩。那么实际上我们看了很多《道德经》的版本，可能。 都有些差出入啊，有些出入解释上面，你有时候至于说想把它讲得很清楚啊，或者说讲得更深入啊，我觉得这个可能也做不到啊，只能说，以个人理解吧，就是自己个人理解啊，如何去这个对这个《道德经》的这么一个啊自己一个领会一个领悟啊。 其实他这个第五章讲的是什么呢？就是说，这个里面我们有很多版本，我们看了一下，就是说大致上就是我的自己的这种理解，大概跟我们这个《道德经》这个智慧的这个可能有所相同啊，我觉得这可能是我跟他的这种理解吧，是一种缘分嘛，我觉得啊。其实他这个第五章，刚才你前面问那个第五章呢，可能他前面还有两株可能是。 是漏掉了，或者说它的版本不同啊。其实他说天地之间起个橐龐，橐龐就是一个什么？就是他可能理解不了，它是一个我们过去就是一种风箱，对不对？他用这个风箱去比喻这个道的这个无穷无尽，就是说在静止的状态里面了，对不对？他你可能看不到它的有多么。 大的这种能量，对不对？实际上，如果你动起来了，对不对？虚的时候它不出，就可能它没有任何的这种形象的东西，或者说没有更大的能量展示。那实际上，如果你动起来呢，对不对？它是无穷无尽的，它很深奥、深邃，对不对？所以说整体的解释呢。 整体的解释下来，就是看它这个是基本上是跟它是相同的。我的意思啊，就天地之间就是正好就是跟那个一个风箱一样。那么在空虚呢，但是它不会这个穷竭，就是说它不会就是说做到这个穷竭就是衰竭的，是没有这种虚的意思，对不对？实际上它是一种强大的一种空灵的那么一种。 一种能量，就是保存在里面了，对不对？它只是在一念之中，对不对？动起来了，那么它这个能量呢，这个风量就很大，对不对？你看我们那个风箱，不知道你见过没有，对不对？就是那个过去我们那个铁匠啊，是吧？大铁不是有个风箱嘛？你拉它动，它那个火就很大，那个风力很大，对不对？那个火就烧得很大。这个你见过吗？以前没见过是吧？没见过，它就很难去理解它，对不对？ 所以说，你越动得快，那个风就越大，对不对？那个火就烧得越旺，对不对？说明它的能量大，对不对？所以呢，如果这样大的话，那么在用到我们日常生活里面来，对不对？就是我们人与人之间啊，言多必失嘛，对不对？说多了话，争论的太多了，对不对？就矛盾就 就纷争了，就开始冲突了，对不对？冲突东西一定是争论过多的时候，意见不合或怎么样的，话语多了，那么就发生争论。那实际上他说多言诉穷，就是说还不如保持的，对不对？沉默啊，然后保持自己的这种智慧，对不对？啊，这样才可以做到什么呢？内心的这种虚静，这种平静。啊，这就是他有表达的意思。实际上他拿一个风箱来讲这么一个大道理，讲道理，天地宇宙的这么一个大道理，一个道理。啊，用一个很简单的一个东西，深入浅出的来讲这个道理。所以说人在不管是国与国之间的这种争论态度，它也发生矛盾，对不对？啊，人与人之间也是这样。那用到我们巫术上面来，养生上面来，其实它都是大道至简，啊，又保持了一个什么呢？一个静虚己这么一个啊，一个状态，它才可以真正的开发自己的这种智慧，对不对？
So in his reply, 师爷 first pointed out that for 道德经。Each individual would have a different understanding. Even interpreting literally from the text, perhaps most of the time, one would still speak only from one's own understanding. Looking at the many 道德经 versions preserved, there are actually some discrepancies in the text. Therefore, to hope to speak of it very clearly or more deeply would perhaps not be possible. Rather, we speak from one's own understanding of how to have a comprehension of the 道德经. So, the first question from 道德经 text comes from chapter 5. The first two sentences have been omitted. It speaks of the 橐月, and what is that? It is a kind of windbox in the old times, used at the blacksmith. Chapter 5 borrows the windbox as the example, as an analogy of the boundlessness of the Tao. In its stillness, one does not see how much power it holds. When it is formless, it does not have any physical image or manifestation of force. So, between heaven and earth, it is just like the windbox. It is empty, yet it does not get depleted. It does not exhaust. You see, it has no form, but it also has no bound. Now, while one would pull on the windbox, the fire grows strong when the wind blows. It shows the power is actually immense. To take this concept to daily life, it leads us to the next sentence, 多言数穷不如守中. Let's say between people, conflicts arise from too much arguments, because disagreements lead to too much speaking and too much words, and then arguments lead to conflicts. So the sentence is basically to say that it is better off to remain in silence and to keep one's wisdom within. By doing so, one can reach inner peace and not have conflicts. That is what the text is trying to express. If we apply the concept also to martial art or to health, in the same way, it means to keep the calm state, like the quiet, empty space in the windbox. It would then be possible to develop one's own wisdom. So that was the translation to the first question. Wudang Academy aims to bring you a comprehensive understanding to the Taoist culture. In the rest of the interview, in addition to interpretations to the 道德经, we have more contents on cultural context and training. See you in the next video.